We want to use a tangent line to approximate the square root of 49.1. To do this, we'll be using the square root function f of x equals the square root of x, and we'll use the tangent line at x equals 49. We're using x equals 49 for two reasons. First, it's close to 49.1, and second, the square root of 49 simplifies perfectly. So the idea is that we can use the equation of this red tangent line at x equals 49 to make an approximation for the green function at x equals 49.1. Notice how the tangent line is a good approximation for the function as long as x is close to 49. But as we get further and further away from x equals 49, the approximations would have more of an error. So to find the equation of the tangent line, we'll have to find the point of tangency as well as the slope of the tangent line. Well, we know x equals 49, so that would be the x-coordinate of the point of tangency. And because the point of tangency is on the square root function, we can evaluate f of 49 to find the corresponding y-coordinate. So f of 49 would just be the square root of 49, which is equal to 7. So the point of tangency is the point 49, 7. And now to find the slope of the tangent line, we can find the derivative function and evaluate the derivative function at x equals 49. So let's work on finding our derivative function. If f of x equals the square root of x, because the index is 2 and the exponent on x is 1, we can write this as x to the 1/2. And now we can find f prime of x by applying the power rule of differentiation. F prime of x would be equal to 1/2 times x to the power of 1/2 minus 1, that would be negative 1/2. To change the sign of the exponent, we can move this to the denominator and write this as 1 divided by 2x to the 1/2, and x to the 1/2 is equal to the square root of x, so we can write this as 1 divided by 2 square root x. Which means the slope of our tangent line at x equals 49 would be equal to f prime of 49, which would be equal to 1 divided by 2 square root 49. Square root of 49 is equal to 7, so we have 1 divided by 2 times 7, or 1/14. So the slope of the tangent line is 1/14. And now we have the information we need to find the equation of the tangent line. So let's continue on the next slide. Using point-slope form of a line, where x sub 1 is equal to 49 and y sub 1 is equal to 7, we would have y minus 7 equals 1/14 times the quantity x minus 49. So now we would distribute. So we'd have y minus 7 equals 1/14 x, and then we'd have minus 1/14 times 49, or times 49 over 1. There are 2 7s in 7 and 7 7s in 49. So we'd have minus 7/2. Add 7 to both sides. So we have y equals 1/14 x minus 7/2 plus 7 over 1. Common denominator would be 2. Multiply 7 over 1 by 2 over 2. So our linear equation would be y equals 1/14 x. And then here we'd have negative 7/2 plus 14/2. That's positive 7/2. So this would be the equation of our tangent line, which we'll use to make our approximation for the square root of 49.1. Let's go ahead and call this L of x equals 1/14 x plus 7/2. So now to make our approximation, we'll find L of 49.1. So we'll have 1/14 times, because we want the exact value of this, 49.1 is equal to 49 1/10. If we convert this to an improper fraction, we'd have tenths, and the numerator would be 10 times 49 plus 1, or 491/10. So we'll go ahead and use this value here, 491/10, and then plus 7/2. Oh, sorry, denominator here is going to be 140. So to write 7 halves as 140ths, we'll have to multiply the numerator and denominator by 70. So we'd have 491 140ths plus 490 140ths. Now that we have a common denominator, our approximation for the square root of 49.1 would be 981 140ths, which does not simplify, so this would be our exact approximation using our tangent line. But if we were asked to round this to four decimal places, let's go ahead and do that as well. 981 divided by 140 to four decimal places would be approximately 7.0071. It's always nice to get the decimal approximation because it does give us an idea of whether our estimate is appropriate. Notice how because the square root of 49 is 7, the square root of 49.1 should be a little larger than 7, which it is. I hope you found this helpful.